Well, hello everyone. I just want to start out the way I would if you were a patient and visiting me for the first time in the medical weight loss clinic. Welcome. And I am so proud of you. I'm so proud of you because I don't even know you yet, but I'm so proud of you because it takes a lot of boldness, it takes a lot of strength and conviction to be open to even entertain the idea of change in your life. So again, welcome and congratulations for being here. For some of you excited go-getters, some of you already know what you want and you're just here to come get it. It's like picking up a paycheck. But for some of you who still aren't too sure about this program, you're gonna find it's gonna be like, kind of like running through full speed through a thick fog to chase a rainbow. You're not quite sure what's out there yet, but when you get there, it's gonna be spectacular. It's gonna be beautiful. And you're gonna be happy that you're there. Just not quite sure, and that's okay. That's all right. Changes isn't easy for everybody. Changes really can be kind of hard and it's uncertain. But there's a certain strength of character. There's a certain a boldness about being able to take that change and run with it. To actively pursue change in the face of all that is a brave and courageous thing to do. So I'm very proud of all of you for just even being here. You know, I spend most of my life helping others. And when people are willing to come out of their comfort zone and break their routine, I find that exciting. So I'm hoping at the end of this talk, you're gonna be just as excited as I am about change and we can get this party started. I'm Dr. Eileen Javellana with the Center for Weight Management at the Gwinnett Medical Center. I've been board certified since 1998 in internal medicine. Internal medicine is a study of how the organ systems interact with each other in the setting of disease. Kind of like heart failure can cause kidney failure. Kidney failure can cause lung failure. Lung failure can cause heart failure. Disease processes can be complicated. I specialize in severe and complicated disease. Obesity is a complicated disease. Most of you already recognize a lot of the complications, coronary artery disease, hypertension, diabetes, that all go along with obesity. For a long time, obesity was just considered a side effect, like the side effect from too little exercise, too much food. Well, we know now that it's not that. There are a lot of different causes for obesity. There are medical reasons for it. There are biochemical signals in the body that can make people obese. And there are definite disease conditions that are caused by obesity. They're not only the structural obesities or load-bearing diseases like osteoarthritis or restrictive lung disease or obstructive sleep apnea. There are chemical, metabolic diseases like blood clots, cancers, liver disease that can be caused by obesity that may go undetected for a long time until it shows up as fulminant, outright organ failure. It's scary. These are silent killers. Back in the day when I went to medical school, they taught us that hypertension, just one of those little guys up there, hypertension, was the silent killer. Well, I'm here to tell you there's another big boy in town, and it's obesity. And he's got a crew of assassins on his team, almost every single one of these things. Stroke, cancer, diabetes, liver disease, they can kill. We all know that smoking's bad for you, right? What if I told you severe obesity was equivalent to smoking in terms of heart attack and stroke risk? It's pretty significant, right? Kind of scary. You're like, oh, I gave up smoking. But obesity isn't just a killer, it's a thief too. With that extra 30 to 50 pounds that you may be carrying, it just robbed you of 3 years of your life. So let's just imagine. The average woman in America is about 5'4". She weighs 162 pounds, that's average. Now, that's 10 pounds heavier than the average that was calculated about 10 years ago, but let's put that aside for a second. At 235 pounds, she loses 6.5 years of her life. At 325 pounds, she loses at least 14. Now take your crystal ball, and let's look and see what her life looks like. It's hospitalizations, it's multiple medications, maybe she's already had a heart attack and a few stents. Maybe she's in the nursing home now, but it's filled with significant limitations on her quality of life. Is it a short and sweet life? Not for her. Short, yes. Sweet, no. Obesity is a killer and a thief, and obesity is your enemy. It's my enemy. The enemy of your enemy is your friend. That's me. This is what I know to be true. But what's true for you? What brought you here? Maybe you have blood pressure issues. Maybe you have blood sugar issues and you want to get off some of your medications. Maybe your orthopedist told you you need to lose a little weight before you get your new knee. For whatever reason that you're here, whether it be social, economic, cosmetic, we all want the same thing in life. We all just want to feel better and live a longer but healthier life. So, congratulations for taking that first step and being here. Like again, I'm so proud of you. Welcome to a new direction. Just last year, the American Medical Association made a landmark decision in declaring obesity a disease. You know, back in the day when I trained, it was all about obesity. Well, that's just a side effect. It's a condition like a rash or a sore throat that's expected to go away on its own. Well, it's not. It's a complicated disease. By them declaring it a disease, it's opened the door for us. It's empowered us in the medical field to attack it from a multidisciplinary approach with treatment and lifestyle changes. We can have multi-specialists work on getting obesity better. It's a chronic disease. It's ongoing, and it's not going away. This is what we're fighting as a nation. Back about 20 years ago, you can see the largest states there in the nation were Indiana and Mississippi. At that time, only one out of every 10 people was obese. Now, fast forward to 2010. More than half the nation has an obesity rate of at least 1 of 4. 1 out of 4. It's spreading. It's getting worse. It's not getting better. And look at diabetes, which is only one of those multiple medical conditions we talked about that's associated with obesity. It's following the same path. By forecasts, according to recent meetings, all show 2020, the whole nation is covered in red. Here are some statistics. More than two-thirds of the nation, of our adult population, are overweight or obese. That's 133 million people. This is statistics from 2008. We're still waiting for the 2014 to come in. And it's not just limited to us adults. It's spreading to our children. Childhood obesity is surging. Obese children will likely grow up to be obese adults. Obese parents, one obese parent is likely to have an obese child. Two obese parents likely cinches the deal for an obese child. And that obese child will become an obese adult, and the cycle continues over and over and over again. It's a real epidemic. This is the epidemic we should be worried about. But if there has to be a comfort in the fact, the comfort there is that you are not alone. Everyone struggles with healthy weight. Everyone, whether they admit it or not, even me. I've been able to keep the weight off for 20 years through 4 pregnancies. So if I can do it, you can do it too. You know what doesn't work for you. You've probably tried some of the fads. You've probably watched what you ate. I've even had some patients come in saying they tried the starvation diet. Starvation diet, kind of an oxymoron. They started some programs they've seen on TV because, hey, if it's good enough for a celebrity, it's got to be good, right? But let's consider this. Obesity is a disease, and it's a complicated one. If you developed cancer, would you be expected to treat that on your own? Would you want to? Or would you want a team of medical experts and specialists to come up and devise a treatment plan for you to get better? Well, we can be that team for you. Our medical program starts with a New Direction product line, which has been on the medical market, FDA approved, for at least the past 20 years. It's been clinically tested and effective in helping people achieve healthy weight. But it isn't alone either. You know, that's not the only thing we use. It's just a tool to help us get through this. While you lose the weight, we work together to attack these three areas: behavior, nutrition, exercise, and we have specialists within each of these groups. Maybe you've had some problems, and that's what's gotten you here to begin with. But we look at everything from every little angle to help you navigate through these areas to find that ultimate sweet spot of optimum weight loss. Our program is simple. There are no complex calculations to do. There's no complex hoops to jump through. Basically, all you have to do is show up and follow the plan. It's real simple. Our results are rapid. Average weight loss is 2 to 5 pounds per week. That's about 20 pounds for the best of you per month. And we can improve obesity-related health issues. It only takes 5 to 10% of your total body weight to lose for you to improve any health conditions that you already have or prevent those health conditions from happening. There are two meal plans. You'll see the word diet there. I consider diet a four-letter word because when I tried to do it, it was akin to pain and suffering. Well, this isn't that. These drinks, some of you have already tried them outside. They're actually pretty good. They're better than Ovaltine, let me tell you. They're medically supervised. The difference between the very low-calorie diet or VLCD and the LCD is the addition of a regular meal that's prescribed and balanced, and it's something that you can pick out yourself or prepare for yourself at home. You will have a team of subspecialists to help you on your journey. All of these people are specially trained in the area of bariatrics or weight management, and each one of them has a specific passion for this, or like I do, or a viewpoint to share with you to help you through your journey. Each one of them is a kind and gentle and warm person. They're not here to persecute you. They're here to help you. They will pick you up when you're down, and they will celebrate with you when you soar. You'll have weekly visits with the bariatric surgeons to not only monitor your weight loss, but your body composition, meaning how much muscle mass you have, how much fat mass you've actually lost. They monitor your vital signs as well. You'll have weekly educational groups with the different subspecialists, the nutritionist, the exercise physiologist or therapist, the behavioralist, on lifestyle changes and building better habits to keep the weight off. And you'll meet with me monthly for regular labs and a physical to just kind of, and at that point I can address some of your individual medical concerns and maybe restructure your medical plan as necessary. There are four phases to the program: screening, reducing, adapting, maintaining. Screening, before you begin the exam, you have a full physical from myself. You have a screening process which includes blood tests, EKGs, a behavioral and nutritional assessment to kind of check on your readiness to start. Reducing phase, this is my favorite part. This is where people start to lose weight, and it really does happen. You get excited about coming to classes. You get excited about how much weight loss. Some people, and then there's almost a contest between some people that only lose 2 and some people that lose 5, you know. It's exciting. They get all, they're together and kind of competing. During this time, like I said, weight loss is about 2 to 5 pounds per week, and the initial goal is only 5 to 10% of your total body weight. Doesn't mean we stop there. It all depends on you. You'll see the bariatric nurses weekly, as well as the group session specialists weekly, and then you'll continue to see me monthly. The adapting phase. This usually occurs when you're about 5 to 10 pounds from your goal weight. Consider this. It's like teaching you to walk again. But here, instead of setting you out on your own, we're holding your hand as you're going through. We start reducing the amount of meal replacements and increasing the food. So you start to, it helps you get back into the real world. Okay? So you're not alone. You'll always have support. This is the maintenance phase. During this time, you're on your own, but we're still here to support you. You graduate into our STAR program, and we're there when you need us. The meal replacements. So they're high protein, low carbohydrate, nutritionally sound, protein is the only macronutrient that can help you actually lose weight. They come in a variety of flavors. They're pretty easy to use, convenient to use, even for the busiest of us. It's as simple as just add water. They come in a variety of flavors. I like the chocolate and the mocha particularly. They also have some savory options for those of you that just want a little something different with a cheddar broccoli soup and chicken cream of chicken soup. And later on, after you're actually into the program, we may hand you a recipe book, which actually helps you play around with some of these things to make solid foods like muffins and chips and pies and little, just kind of nice little thing. If you like to cook, it'll kind of settle that little spot for you. We'll focus on your behavior, your nutrition, and your fitness. You'll have weekly education classes, which are really designed to kind of help raise awareness, kind of help teach you mindful eating, get you starting to think about how to move forward and how to arm yourself with the tools that we give you in real life situations so you can achieve a healthy weight. You'll learn from us, you'll learn from your peers. It helps people stay grounded and connected. We look at your social side. You learn to control the food so that it doesn't control you. You learn about what may trigger you, boredom, anxiety, depression, whatever it is, and how to change that into a healthier behavior rather than just turning to food. Food doesn't have to be a threat. You'll practice mindful eating and learn to take care of yourself. We look at nutrition. There are a lot of evidence-based and a lot of studies going on to help support all the nutritional ideas that we have here in terms of giving you more protein, giving you less carbs, strong tools to help you maintain your weight loss. Fitness education. I like this slide because it says fitness. I find that a less daunting concept than exercise. Exercise to me sounds hard, like you have to put on a superhero outfit and join an expensive gym. It doesn't have to be that. It just has to be regular activity. So I know you may be worried about the cost of the program, but let's look at what obesity is costing you. It's a threat to your health. It's a threat to your financial health. It's the threat to the way you connect with the world. Here's the threat to your health again. These are all the assassins we talked about. But I think you get the point. Remember the crystal ball and the quality of life? I spent a lot of time as an internist adding medications and trying to juggle medications just to control disease. I get the chance now, doing bariatric medicine, to take people off their medications, to take people off their blood pressure, to stop the insulin and get them feeling better. It's amazing. How many other doctors get to say that? Obesity is stealing your money. It's a thief. In 2009, it's estimated that over $147 billion were spent on treating obesity in adults. That's, again, not counting children. People who were obese spent about $1,400 more per year than their average counterparts that were normal weight. They spent that's 42% more on medical care. And for whatever reason, earned $7,000 less per year. Presumably due to either physical limitations, sick days, all those other disease complications that we talked about. But what about the things you can't put a price tag on? We all have some emotional baggage, but is it coming from your weight? Does your weight change the way you perceive yourself or how you think others perceive you? Do social situations give you a second thought? Does the word swimsuit make you shudder? Do you sit on the beach in a cover-up while the rest of your family is frolicking in the ocean? Are you sitting on the sidelines while everybody else is playing the game of life? This is a price to you that is, this is a cost and a price to you that is immeasurable. I panned it out for my children. Cost of a fast food meal, $5.71. Cost to connect with other people and and interact and live and enjoy life, priceless. This program can save you in more ways than one. Better health, less disease. Join in all the activities that you've been missing that we just talked about. Building good habits. Less eating out, less food shopping means less weekly grocery bills. Spending your money where you want to, not where you have to. Feeling better about yourself. Remember, obesity is a disease, and you shouldn't have to treat it alone. You can steal back what obesity stole from you. This program can provide you the tools that you need to develop a healthy diet, to stay in a safe and open environment where you can learn and get better. We teach you how to cope and with your thoughts and your feelings and maybe modify your behavior to teach you better habits. We help support you in your long-term goals, both short-term and long-term, to keep you on track. We don't let you go. I tell all my patients, I treat you just as I would my own family. And when you enter this program, you're part of my family. I'm looking out after you, and I'll get on you just like I would my own family. The American Society of Bariatric Physicians tells us all the time that we should have a toolbox as medical care providers. Well, we're going to pass on that toolbox to you. If you need individual consults for behavior or nutrition or individual personal fitness or life coaching classes, we have that. If you need cooking classes or free clothes, well, as you search and find that thinner you within, we have that as well. We want this to be an open and welcoming, inviting environment for you to come and feel safe in. You've been on this road for a while, and without help, studies show that you will gain 1 to 3 pounds per year without any intervention. 1 to 3 pounds for whatever time you have left on this world. Isn't it time for a change? Now is the time to stop and get off this road and get onto a healthier one. What is it worth to you and to your family and those people that you love and love you? Now is the time for change because you can make a difference in your life and theirs. Remember that cycle we talked about? It's contagious, and losing weight can be contagious as well. So are you ready? We are too. Program fees may vary depending on your insurance coverage, but we will apply these bills to insurance. There'll be flexible payment options for self-pay, multi. You'll also meet with our financial counselor to review the details. Where there's a will, there's a way. What's next? Get started now. Select the Get Started Now icon below. Complete insurance information from the form after clicking the Get Started Now icon. And wait for a call from us to review the payment options. Thank you for your time. If you have any questions, you can feel free to call us at 678-312-6200. Thank you.